All right, yeah, we love her. And you know, this would be funny. Don Crosini is retiring.
Yes.
KTLA's new general manager. We're introducing her now. She's only 16.
Olivia's like, what?
Olivia Sanabia is like, sure. Because you look like you have the poise and maturity to do it.
Thank you.
If you were running the TV station, what would you do?
I don't know. I would.
Give us reasons.
Yes.
Sure. Oh,
that
yes.
would be the first thing I would
okay.
do, for sure.
Well, then you're in. Congratulations. You enjoy her in Disney Channel's Coop and Cammy Ask the World. Amazon's Prime just had Magic Now returning to her theater roots in a Snow White Christmas. Olivia, nice to have you here. Nigel Lythgoe has been here over the years talking about these pantos. They are so much fun. This one in the Pasadena Civic, which is often they take place in the Pasadena area. Tell us what this one's about.
This one is a Snow White Christmas, and I play Snow White. So this is kind of our take on the classic fairy tale. Mm-hmm. So there's contemporary music and you know, the classic panto style, so the kids can boo and cheer for the
That's
good
fun.
guys, and it's really an interactive experience, and there's music for everybody, stuff that your grandparents know, stuff that your young kids know, so there's really something for everyone. There's adult humor, there's kids humor, and there's really something for everybody to enjoy.
And there's a lovely informality to this, because the idea of, gee, my kids are too young, they're not going to sit in a theater
right.
and behave.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to us about that idea.
It's the perfect introduction to theater for kids. Mm. I remember growing up as a kid, I went to the theater and just wanted to sing and be up there dancing with everybody.
Right.
So kids really feel like they're a part of the story and the experience when they get to boo and cheer. So that's so fun as an audience member, but also as an actor, getting to incorporate them into our story.
Our producer, Claudine, says her hair is absolutely remarkable. How many, how
is.
Often does she brush it? How many brushes per night before bed?
Oh, 100 brushes a night.
Really?
No.
Okay.
No,
there's no like regimen to keep it.
You know what? I think I have good genes.
All right.
There's no regimen.
Okay.
No.
Speaking of good genes, you're a big singer. We're gonna play Star-Crossed in just a second. Talk to us about this a little bit. It seems often there's kind of a Disney Channel arc. You do the show and then.
You know what? Music has always been a part of my life, and it was actually kind of my first love. I love singing since I was 2 years old, and so music was always something that I wanted to do, but it was always a matter of when and when I found my sound. So this is my debut single.
Oh, great. What's Star-Crossed about?
It is based on, people ask me this and I'm like, it's half based on an idea and half based on my love for Romeo and Juliet.
Oh.
So there's several references in there, actually some quotes of Shakespeare itself, so.
All right,
yeah.
Here we go. Let's take a listen.
I think we got our stars crossed somewhere in the middle. When the nights grow colder and slow down the time, we both had our demons blinded by a feeling. And when I faced the music, it just wasn't right. I guess our stars.
Oh, that really sounds good. You know what?
Thanks
if you
so
lead
much.
The KTLA staff meetings in your new position with a song,
yes.
I think that would be a good
that's
way to get...
That's the change
yeah.
that I'm going to make. Everybody
okay.
has to sing.
Right.
Instead.
That would be a good way to get everybody to pay attention.
Right?
Just the on-camera work that you've done, Kim and Cam and these other shows, the distinction between that and doing something like this in person in front of people.
Oh, you know, it's... The instant gratification you get from an audience is unlike anything else. It truly is such an experience to... you know, perform and then have the audience talk back to you. Mm. Or you can really feel the energy, whereas TV, you kind of have to wait a while to get a response if you even get one. So it's a lot of fun.
There is this deeply poised 38-year-old trapped inside your 16-year-old self. It's really
remarkable.
Terrifying.
Yeah.
Join Olivia at the Lythgoe Family Pantos, A Snow White Christmas, happening till Sunday, December 22nd, Pasadena Civic Auditorium. Ticket information, AmericanPanto.com. It's Don Corsini Day on KTLA. Quick break here, and we jump back in just a minute. Thank you.